So folks, welcome back to another video. Today we're going to dive into Google Tasks and how to get started. We're going to overview how it works and also a little bit more about how it interacts with Gmail, allowing you to save any emails you create as tasks. Now, Google Tasks is probably best for the folks that are looking for a lightweight to-do list application. It's not going to be anything as advanced as a Todoist and TickTick. However, it will provide you a way to take simple tasks down, schedule them for later, and even create some nice lists. And you can use it free with any of your Google accounts, including Google Workspace. Now, let's start with where you can find Google Tasks. You can actually use it through web. Although it doesn't have a dedicated web application, you can view it via Google Calendar or any of the other Google applications by using it on the right-hand side of the screen. So you'll almost get a little skinny edition on the right-hand side for you to manage your tasks. You can also download it on iOS and Android. And the actual iOS and Android applications have a really high rating as it's quite a well-built application. Now, before we dive into some of the Gmail and Google Calendar event abilities, let's start with some of the basic functions. So to create some new tasks, you can do it through two different ways. You can add it to your My Tasks area, which is a pre-created list and is essentially the default list that you can create inside of your Google Tasks. Or you can create a brand new list. Creating a brand new list is really simple. And as you can see, it's empty when you get started. Now on the mobile application, you can press the plus at the bottom to create a brand new task. And tasks can be added with simple task titles, and also you can add some more detail, which serves as a description to add a little bit more context. Now you can add a date and a time, and you can even set it to repeat as well. This is great for something that you might do on a routine basis, like maybe even meditate, or for something that you need a due date on, like an assignment, or a piece of work that you're doing at work. A lot of people like the ability inside of Google Tasks because it allows you to see it next to, say, your emails, your Google Calendar, and any other Google services you and your team might be using already. Now, as you can imagine, creating a task is quite easy. And once you have it up there, you can do a few things when it comes to sorting the order of them. You can change it to your order or the date. And you can even copy all the reminders to tasks as well, delete the list and rename it as well. Now inside of the mobile applications, this is all that you can really do. But you can go inside of task settings and change a few things in the iOS version, like some of the defaults that you might suggest and connect up later. Now Google Tasks reminds me very much of Google Keep. Although Google Keep is a little bit further on, it's a very basic experience you get with this application in terms of be able to create lists and tasks themselves. You probably get more of an advanced experience even with something like Microsoft To Do. But what a lot of people like is having everything in their Google ecosystem and even alongside Google Keep as well. So as you can imagine, one of the features that is particularly famed inside of Google Keep and for a lot of people who work with Google Workspace is the ability to create a task from an email. Now I'm also going to touch on a little feature as well which is beneficial for breaking down a task. So if you're inside a Gmail and you can bring up on the right-hand side of Google Tasks, you can drag any emails as a task inside of the account. Now this will deep link it, which basically means that if you click into that task, it'll bring up that Gmail, which is perfect when you're inside the application for adding context, or even when you're inside of the web version for bringing up that Gmail extension. Now inside of a task, you can also go into the detail, change the seat details, date and time, but also add something called subtasks, which is perfect for adding and breaking down a particular project. You could also move the task to a list as well in the mobile version, and that's really helpful as well. As well as being able to complete it, which means it goes into your completed section for the day. Now, when I mentioned Google Calendar, it does allow you whenever you create an event, if you've added a specific time and date, it will now appear inside of your calendar, which appears if you don't select specific time as an all day event, or if you specifically choose a time, it'll come up alongside that. A lot of people like this because it helps them keep reminded of what they need to focus on, but a lot of people don't like this because if you've got something like Google Home and also Google Calendar and also Google Tasks, it might become overwhelmed and a bit too much for example, to be able to, you know, store inside of your calendar. So it's really preferential, but it's a nice addition if you do want to embed that connect up with your Google Calendar. So that gives you a bit of an overview about how Google Tasks works. You can download it on iOS and Android, but all you need is an active Google account or an active Google Workspace account to get started. And it does come with some really helpful features for creating very simple tasks. And one of the killer features is that Gmail ability, because a lot of people struggle with emails. But my biggest note to you guys is that it is a lightweight to-do-list application, so do note that when you're choosing the resource. So folks, if you're new here, it'd be amazing to have you as a subscriber to keep productive. We do plenty of videos covering Google and many more applications that you may know and love already. So folks, please do subscribe, please do like the video if you enjoyed it, and feel free to comment below with any questions you might have about Google Tasks. Thanks very much, folks, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio!